I don't really talk a lot, not when it comes to crowds. I've always been called the quiet one. Even my laugh was not too loud. So although I know this is hard for you and I know you're sad today, I've never been one with a lot of words, so I'll keep short what I'd like to say. Oh yeah, you'll never guess who all I saw when I got here the other day. I was so hyped, they were smiling so big, so let me assure you, I'm okay. I would like to thank my big head sister, who of course thought she was my mom, bossing me and yet teaching me, but always remaining calm. Misha, you don't know how cool it was to have you as my big sis. Your unwavering love for a kid like me was more than I could wish. And so I want you to know, I think you're really good at everything. May Colin and Coleman always know God gave them a beautiful queen. Although they could never beat me in basketball, though they tried again and again, may they always respect and take care of you as they grow into great young men. Thank you, Dad, for all you've done to give our home the best. You were the kind of dad that stood out to me and better than all the rest. I'm glad that you taught me to work hard and that family after God comes first. Your example always reminded me, no matter my trouble, it could always be worse. I love you a lot, and there's one thing that makes me grateful, that makes me glad, that God thought enough of me that I got to have you as my dad. And of course, Mom, I saved you for last because I know how you feel about me. I know this was unexpected to you. This is not how it's supposed to be. But I can tell you, this is exactly right. God has his perfect plan. I wish sometimes we knew what it was, but when he moves, he doesn't have to ask man. You are my sunshine, my hope, and my encourager, and I could even call you my friend because you are the kind of mom that I could honestly say on you I could depend. I could depend on you for laughter and love and correction and even joy. I could depend on you to provide me anything, even as a child, an expensive toy. There is nothing you wouldn't do for me. You are my biggest cheerleader in life, making me feel like the talents I had were only limited by the sky. I love you, Mom, and I know only God in time can wipe your tears away. But please know with confidence your little boy is really okay. To my best friend Rico, my cousins and co-workers, and to all of my other friends, to my grandparents and aunts and uncles, to those who've loved me to the end. I hope you will include God in your life. There really is only one way to be. Live for Jesus while you have a chance, so you can always declare, God's got me. Live and love like it's your last day, because you never know when he'll call. You never know when he needs you home, so on his word, you should always stand tall. Well, I hear God calling my name again, so I really have to go. But there is this one little thing I thought you'd like to know. When God called me home, he said, "It's an emergency, Cameron Lee." He said he needed his best manager back, and he said that angel was me. How could managing a pizza place get me a manager position here? God said, "You were already a manager. I just let your family enjoy you for 29 years. "Huh? I don't understand," I said. God said, "You were an angel in disguise, and even your real name and title when you got to Earth we had to hide. They called you Cam for Cameron, short for what they thought was your name. But Cam stands for chosen as management. You're the best one I got in the game."